Hi, my name is Javelin May Epabunan from DBSCCE, third year. And I will start my report by briefly discussing what is an OSI model. So OSI stands for the Open Systems Interconnection. It is the conceptual framework for applications to communicate over a network. It is how data are being transferred from one computer to another. So, in the most basic form, two computers are connected to each by LAN cable, and connectors sharing data with the help of the network interface card forms a computer network. But what if we connect two computers? One is based on Microsoft Windows, and one is based on the Mac OS. So, paano sila makapag-communicate or paano natin mako-connect yun if hindi sila compatible? That was where OSI was introduced. So, OSI describes 7 layers that computer system used to communicate over a network. It was the first standard model for network communication, adopted by all major computer and telecommunication companies in the early 1980s. So, the OSI model was introduced by the ISO, or the International Organization for Standardization, in 1984. Here's the 7 layers of the OSI model: the application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. And today I will be discussing the presentation layer, or the 6th layer of the OSI model. So, the presentation layer is layer 6 of the 7 layer Open Systems Interconnection, or the OSI model. It is used to represent data to the application layer, or the layer 7, in an accurate, well-defined, and standardized format. The presentation layer is responsible for the delivery and formatting of information to the application layer for further processing or display. The presentation layer is sometimes called the syntax layer. So, the presentation layer receives data from the application layer. Presentation layer has 3 basic functions. First is the translation, second is data compression, third is encryption or decryption. Translation. The presentation layer converts the data sent by the application layer of the transmitting node into an acceptable and compatible data format based on the applicable network protocol and architecture. For example, this is a situational example. We have a French person here, Frenchian, and American person. So, they have different languages and they can't understand each other kasi nga magkaiba yung language nila. So, kailangan nila ng translator para magkaintindihan at magkaroon ng communication. So, ganun din sa computer. The data that is composed of characters and numbers are being transferred or translate into a machine understandable format para makapag-communicate sila. So, here's another example. The presentation layer translates from the American Standard Code for the Information Interchange, or the ASCII, to the Extended Binary Code Decimal Interchange Code, or the EBCD. So, here are the characters under the EBCD table. So, we also have the ASCII table. This is the characters under the ASCII table. So, for the next function, we have the data compression. The primary role of data compression is to reduce the number of bits to be transmitted. Multimedia files such as audio and video are bigger than text files, and compression is more important. There are two general types of compression algorithms. First is the lossless compression, and second is the lossy compression. So, diba, sa pagta-transfer ng files, mas mabilis na ta-transfer ang files if mas maliit yung size niya. So, yun ang purpose ng data compression. Sa presentation layer, nire-reduce niya yung number ng bits bago i-transfer. So, let me discuss the two algorithms. So, first is the lossless compression. Compresses the data in such a way that when data is decompressed, it is exactly the same as it was before compression. There is no loss of data. Lossless compression algorithms run length encoding, differential pulse code modulation, and dictionary-based encoding. So, sa lossy compression naman, lossy compression is the one that does not promise that the data received is exactly the same as data sent. The data may be lost. This is because lossy algorithm removes information that it cannot later restore. Lossy algorithms are used to compress still image, videos, and audio. So, ang pinagkaiba lang yung dalawa, pag sinabi natin lossless, pag nag-compress ng data, pag dinecompress, exactly yun pa rin at walang nagbago, walang nawala. Sa lossy compression naman, pag dinecompress natin, may nawawala. So, hindi na siya magiging original data kasi may mga nawala. So, yun lang po pinagkaiba ng ating lossless compression and lossy compression. So, yan. Kapag nasa sender, magko-compress. Then, pag na-receive, mag-decompress. So, for the last function of the presentation layer, we have the encryption or decryption. So, encryption is the process of ciphering message information in such a way that the only concerned nodes, systems, or device can read it. Decryption reverses the process. It put the encoded message or the information back into its original form. Sensitive information in most of the time transmitted between nodes through the internet, and if the data is not encrypted, it may be at stake. So, to carry sensitive information, a system must be able to ensure privacy. So, encryption used to maintain the integrity of data before transmission. So, data must always be encrypted before transmitted. Before transmission. So, encryption is important because it enhances the security of the sensitive data. So, encryption is used to maintain the integrity of data before transmission. So, data must always be encrypted before transmitted. The importance of encryption is it enhances the security of the sensitive data. If the data is in the receiver side, the data is being encrypted. If the data is at the receiver, the data is being decrypted. So, for the summary of the presentation layer, so again, the presentation layer ensures that the communications that pass through it are in the appropriate form for the recipient application. In other words, it presents the data in a readable format from application layer perspective. So, there are three major functions: the translation, data compression, in the encryption or decryption.
So, after the data is being transferred from the application layer, the presentation layer translates, compress, and encrypt the data before transmission.
So, thank you for listening. I hope you learned something. Again, I am Jobeline, and thank you so much. Bye-bye!